If you've been watching the Democratic debates, you know that Joe Biden likes to spin some long, sometimes complicated, both for the viewer and also for the person saying it, stories from time to time. Well, that apparently has been going on for some time, because a video from 2017 recently was unearthed, and it involves Joe Biden at a pool telling a story about his run-in with Corn Pop. And it's a little bit of a weird story, but we're going to run through it and see if there's anything we can learn from this. Now, we would love to play you the video, but it's from a local news source and they will literally destroy our entire lives. So I'm just gonna read what Biden said. I'm gonna go through it kind of fast because it's a little bit long. So it might sound a little bit more put together, but at some point you should listen to the video and know that it's a little bit rambly and weird. So he says, Corn Pop was a bad dude and he ran a bunch of bad boys. And back in those days, to show how things have changed, one of the things you had to use, if you used pomade in your hair, you had to wear a baby cap. And so he was up on the board, again, this is at a pool where Joe Biden was apparently a lifeguard 125 years ago, and wouldn't listen to me. I said, hey Esther, you off the board or I'll come up and drag you off. Well, he came off and he said, I'll meet you outside. My car was mostly, these were all public housing behind us, he's gesturing off in the distance. My car, there was a gate on here. I parked my car outside the gate and he said, I'll be waiting for you. He was waiting for me with three guys with straight razors, not a joke. There was a guy named Bill Wright, the only white guy, and he did all the pools. He was a mechanic. And I said, what am I gonna do? And he said, come down here in the basement where all the mechanics, where all the pool builder is. You know the chain? There used to be a chain that went across the deep end. And he cut off a 6-foot length of chain and folded it up and he said, you walk out with that chain and you walk to the car and you say, you may cut me, man, but I'm gonna wrap this chain around your head. I said, you're kidding me. He said, no, if you don't come back. And he was right. So I walked out with the chain and I walked up to my car. And in those days, you remember the straight razors? You had to bang them on the curb, getting them rusty, putting them in the rain barrel, getting them rusty. And I looked at him, but I was smart then. I said, first of all, when I tell you to get off the board, you get off the board and I'll kick you out again, but I shouldn't have called you Esther Williams and I apologize for that. I apologize, but I didn't know that apology was gonna work. And Joe Biden went unstraight razored that day and lived to lifeguard another day.
So my thing is, what is the point of telling this story? We can spend a lot of time on whether it makes sense, mm-hmm. whether Corn Pop exists as a former gang leader. What is the point of telling this story? Is Joe Biden looking for a hood pass?
So, oh, okay. I wasn't sure if you meant what was the point of him telling or what was the point of me telling.
No.
Because I'm not really sure of either. But this was how I spent my weekend with Corn Pop, with people photoshopping
corn. I'm
not
talking about you. I'm just wondering.
Yes.
What is even the point? It obviously it feels like, hey, let me tell you how I click with the blacks.
My guess would be that that's what it is.
Okay,
he was surrounded by black people. He was in other parts of the story, which again, you can watch this whole video. We're not gonna show you 10 minutes of local news footage. He said that he had been a lifeguard back in blank small town America. And one of the things that made him interesting to the people who went there, because mm-hmm. it was predominantly black swimmers, was that they had never talked to a white person before except
for
him.
Which also cannot be possible in a city that is like more than 70% white. No black person has that experience. What?
No, first of all, Joe Biden just said that they had that experience, so I don't know where this is coming from.
So I would guess
that what you guessed is why.
Okay.
That he told the story of Corn Pop, who by the way, I don't know for sure if the story is true. I have a feeling it's embellished. But Corn Pop apparently did live. If you bring this up, this is from Daniel Dale on Twitter. There was an obituary for Mr. Pop, as he is known. Second from the left, William Morris Corn Pop. So he did live. I believe he was a member of either the Romans or the dragon head, golden dragon head chompers. Biden has told multiple stories.
Does it say that in his obituary?
That I don't think is in the obituary.
Okay, because we are not gonna take this elderly man that passed away and could have had this sweet nickname from his grandma. We're not gonna call him a gang leader, okay?
Yeah, okay.
We just know that there was a black person
named Corn Pop
in Delaware who was nicknamed after cereal. And it's a delicious
suspiciously named after cereal. So as a lot of people have pointed out, the whole thing seems odd. And yes, there's the obituary and supposedly a close associate of Joe Biden confirmed that he knew of Corn Pop at the time, contemporaneously. Maybe that's true. Story's still weird. You're talking about straight razors and beating somebody, choking him with a chain. He's surrounded by children, by the way. It is a public pool after all. And look, it is a very rambling performance. Now, the upside for Joe Biden is that it was an incredibly rambling performance where he had a hard time getting his thoughts together and he sounded like everyone's great granddad. But that was in 2017, which means that this is not a new thing for him. He has had these problems for a couple of years. But it's a really weird story.
It is, and you know what? Black people aren't so weird and dangerous and scary and spooky that you get points because you spoke to one.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, I just think just even telling this and the reason behind telling this, before even getting to how weird it is and how it's likely a lie and how it's just so outrageous, just the fact that, so what?
I am curious if at the next debate someone will ask him about corn pop.
I just hope they don't.
I hope they don't.
Because honestly, I wish now that if we could go back that he wasn't asked about his comments about slavery not being his problem. I wish that he wasn't, because then we wouldn't have had to sit through this weird pushing of this horrible false rhetoric.
The record player?
That black people can't be good parents.
Because they don't, because their kids don't hear words.
Because their kids don't hear words.
I know.
And they don't know how to parent. They want to parent. They don't know how to parent.
So they should be taught. Yeah. Yeah, there was a little bit of conversation about that, but he kind of just skated by. That was fine. But it's that with like the corn pop, it's like, starts to sort of paint a picture at some point.
Yeah.
And it's a certain picture. I'm not saying it's the picture, but it's a certain picture. And I think it's worth having a conversation about, a conversation that at least by the mainstream media has not even started to happen yet. By the way, Esther Williams was an American competitive swimmer, so he was calling corn pop a girl when he told him to get off the thing. So just to give you another idea. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.